Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of On the Ice. I'm your host, Andrew Greenall. Today we are joined by two interesting individuals. One is Mr. Mark Fleming, one of the co-owners of Fleming Hockey School. It's based out of Alberta. And then we're also going to be joined by Carly Haggard, the head coach of the Shawnigan female U18 team that plays in the CSSHL. We want to touch base with both of them just to see what's coming up this spring and summer, and also to touch on how scouting's been going, especially for Shawnigan being way out there in Victoria, BC, which is where I wish I could be most days because it's so nice out there. Why wouldn't you want to go all the way out there? But then I'm sure that Mark will have his argument about being in Alberta, and he'll want to be here too. It's like I am, you know, I like the Chinooks here in Calgary, but, you know, overall, actually, I'd rather be in Cuba, to be quite honest with you. I think that's a good place we should all go. So let's pack up the show. We'll talk to the owner. We'll go live from Cuba and we'll do shows out there where it's nice and warm. And yeah, I think we'll do that. I think that'll be, you know, a little bit funner. Anyhow, so we want to talk to them today about some of the things that's going on. And you'll notice over the next few days that ASTV is slowly changing the way that we're broadcasting. We're definitely growing. We're looking for more advertisers. So if you're interested, please hit us up at our address over here at astvproductions.com and speak to one of our sales representatives, and we'd be happy to have you part of the family. So without further ado, let's bring on Mr. Mark Fleming and see what's shaking in Alberta and what his camp offers young athletes clear across Alberta and I'm assuming BC and Saskatchewan as well. See you soon. Everybody! Welcome to the show, Mr. Mark Fleming. You're looking good, young man. Haven't seen you in a while. It's you look pretty chill and laid back there, buddy. You look mellow considering you live in Alberta like I, and it's been up and down. So how are you?
I'm good. Yeah. Enjoying a little bit warmer weather and looking forward to spring and summer.
Yeah, that's right. It's definitely going to be a change going into spring this season with some of the rules and regulations in place. Mark, let's talk to you guys about the Fleming Hockey School that you guys created, how long it's been created, how long it's been around, what you guys have been doing to help young players, both female and male out there. So let's start. How did the Fleming Hockey School come about?
Well, the Fleming Hockey School really starts and ends with my dad, Jim Fleming. So he's 80 years old now, and he started the Fleming Hockey School about 21 years ago. So he had previously ran a hockey school in Vermilion back in the 70s and 80s. So he knew how to start up and run a hockey school. And he really wanted to do one with his sons and really get a kind of a family business going where we all love hockey. We love being on the ice with kids and we could share that passion with each other and with the youth in the Edmonton area.
Hmm. Now, you guys have been around for quite some time, having quite a few individuals come out and help you guys on the ice. Who are some of the instructors and coaches that you guys have? It's not just yourself and your brother that I understand that are running it. There's you got quite the ensemble of individuals.
Yeah, I mean, you know, running through the family, we have I guess my dad's granddaughter Jacqueline, who's playing AAA hockey with the Pandas, and she's got a contract to play with UBC Thunderbirds. And that's been a bit of an impetus for us to say, you know, maybe we should actually have a dedicated girls division. So this year we're going to have a dedicated girls division within the school. Jacqueline will be helping us out with that. You know, we have Nick Harder, who's a local product of the Sherwood Park Minor Hockey Association. Also a phys ed teacher with a pretty extensive background with Grant McEwen and so on. And then we have Eric Tomusiak as our goaltender instructor. And he's also from the Edmonton area. And he's been around coaching hockey for about goaltenders, basically for the last 6 years or so.
So when the program first started up, how did it look? How was your dad able to recruit players? What did registration look like back in the day, and has it grown over the years?
So initially we were in Sherwood Park, and now we're in Mill Woods, and we only had one sheet of ice. And so we really just had, you know, the four instructors, and we had four age groups. So each age group is on the ice for 2 hours, and then kind of in between they have some off ice activities. So it was really the four of us putting in 10-hour days to get the four age groups of, you know, 20 to 25 kids through the, you know, power skating skills in the morning and then hockey skills in the afternoon. And now we've grown to where we have two sheets of ice. So basically our staff size has doubled. It's a lot more manageable. You know, we put in a 4 or 5 hour day, and then we still have time to relax and golf in the afternoon or do something other than just be on the ice with young kids.
What could a player expect to see with the Fleming Hockey School? What skills will I develop? What type of instruction will I receive?
So, you know, the emphasis is that this is a skills camp. It's not a conditioning camp. I mean, we do some amounts of conditioning, but it's really strong emphasis on skills. So, you know, Jim and the other head instructor, Kevin, they're very focused. They're phys ed teachers, so they know how to teach, and they're going to teach skills. They're going to teach power skating skills. They're going to teach edge work, you know, more simple for the younger kids, much more advanced for the older ones. We're going to teach kids how to stick handle properly, how to shoot, and even some of the thinking aspects of the game, a little bit of the, you know, kind of the read and react. So it's very much a teaching focused and skills focused camp.
So obviously being around for over 21 years, the camp has grown through its years. Who are some of the players that you could maybe share with us that have gone through the camp that have now moved on to bigger and better things?
I mean, some of the ones I don't do a great job of keeping track, but definitely, you know, Nick Carter would be one that has come up through the ranks. There's a few from Smoky Lake. There's one, I think he's moved on to Hockey Canada. He's got a role with Hockey Canada now. I think Jesse Hill was in our camp and now moved on. So there's definitely been, you know, some people that have come through the camp and moved on to either, you know, higher level hockey and or teaching within hockey.
Now you stated that the camp focuses quite a bit, not just on the conditioning, but more so on the skills development. What have you noticed over the years, Mark? Like I've known you personally for a few years now, but what have you noticed over the years that's lacking with our MHA, so our minor hockey associations, in trying to teach or trying to develop these players with skills? And why so are more camps such as yours being more emphasis on them, if you will, of helping a player develop their skills?
I mean, I think some of the things, even the you know, basic forward skating, you know, the stride, the forward skating stride and the backward stride, I think are underdeveloped within a lot of the minor hockey now. I mean, there's very much a small area games focus, and small area games are they have their place. But for a young player who's starting out in development, you know, if you're on the weaker end and now you're losing all the games, then when are you developing skills? So we are really focusing on, you know, the fundamentals, the skating, proper tight turns, proper stick handling. And we still want to make it fun. I mean, we play some ball tag, and we try to keep the kids moving a lot so that they're also, you know, learning by doing is becoming more part of our fabric than maybe it was initially. So we're growing in our approaches as well. But, you know, we do want to make sure that there is that teaching focus and, you know, the kids grow and develop through the camp.
Mm-hmm. could you share with us the, I'm trying to think of how to word it, the ages that you guys have been able to work with over the years? Like, do we start at the little U9s and move our way up, or is there a specific age group that you guys have been focusing on for the last few years?
I mean, the age of the kids in the camp is typically about age 6 to 15. So it's very focused on, you know, especially the, with it being a skills development camp, our sweet spot for enrollment is probably age about 7 to 13, where we really find, you know, the kids are old enough to, you know, understand the teaching points, they're listening, they're old enough to be focused, and they're, you know, basically really absorbing what we're doing. And then, of course, we really enjoy working with the older kids, you know, that 12 to 15 year old age group, where they've got the fundamentals down, but it's amazing how even some of the very good hockey players, they'll have a weakness, you know, their stride, they'll be wide tracking with their stride, or they'll have one edge that's weak, and, you know, and you can find that and really work with them on it and, you know, help them improve through a week of the camp.
Mm-hmm. Mark, we have to take a quick commercial break, Krister. We'll be right back with some more of Mark.
Why go solar? Solar is better than ever. Our revolutionary design and inverter equipment with the latest in solar panel technology for the ultimate in-home and business security. That's right, I said security. Grid security and security of your home are linked. Fortify your future today with a battery backup system. No maintenance, quiet running. Did you know in Manitoba, grid-connected, off-grid, and battery backup systems are 100% right off in the year you purchase for any company or farm? Do you want to back up your internet, keep your tills running, and the lights on? We can install a system that is right for you with battery backup fully capable of taking on all those essential loads and keeping you running. When you call our experts at Evolve Green, ask about getting your free energy audit today. Call or email today to find out what system works best for you. 1-866-5-EVOLVE or support@evolvegreen.ca. Also, be sure to check out our website at www.evolvegreen.ca.
Welcome back to On the Ice. I'm your host, Andrew Grinnell, joined by Mr. Mark Fleming, one of the owners of Fleming Hockey School. Fleming Hockey Skills Camps. Mark, I understand that there's a camp coming up, just reading some notes here, August 16th to 20th, being hosted at Millwoods Arena. What's that going to look like for the young players? What would the typical day look like?
Yeah, that's a great question. So, you know, basically we start with the youngest players coming on the ice first, and then we move to the little bit older ones. But basically, you know, you're on the ice starting, say, around 9 a.m. They're on the ice for an hour. There's about an hour and a half break. They're going, during which they'll have a camp counselor with them, and they'll do an off-ice activity. And the off-ice activities vary. One day it could be ball hockey, it could be soccer, it could be off-ice conditioning. So our off-ice instructors are also basically teachers by trade, and they'll be working with the kids on those different activities. And then they kind of come back, get a quick snack in that time, then they're back in the dressing room on the ice for another hour. In the morning, they're doing power skating, and in the later session, they're doing hockey skills. And basically, after being there for 3.5 hours, they'll have done 2 hours of on ice and about 35 or 40 minutes of off ice activity, and they'll be ready for a big meal and maybe a nap, depending on the kid.
Meanwhile, all the parents that are watching this are going, "Are you kidding me? My kid's not going to have a nap." with the instruction that's going to be offered, could you maybe tell our viewers what the ratio is going to be? Is it one or two instructors on the ice? Is it split ice? What's it going to look like for little Johnny and little Sally that show up?
So typically we'll have four instructors on the ice, up to five with the goalie instructor as well, and approximately, 25 kids. So the ratio of, instructor to student is about 6 to 1. Last year with our oldest group, we ran 5 mini stations. We put an extra body out there to help out with our oldest group. And we ran the 5 mini stations, and it really helped because, we want to keep the kids, moving and active and getting, some of that almost individual attention where we can really help with the skill development and growth.
I can't recall if I've asked this, but I do have it jotted down. What do you foresee being some of the issues that a lot of the kids are faced nowadays with their development? Is it just they're not getting proper coaching, or is it that they're just not receiving that one-on-one, specialized training in something? Is it, have you guys noticed or seen or know what some of the issues may be out there? I can't recall if I asked you that.
I think you asked me a similar question, but I think this one's a little different. I mean, I think part of what happens is, the coaches in minor hockey are, they're dads and they're well-intended, but they don't know what they don't know. And, they don't necessarily know the things that we know around, the proper stride, the proper technique for stick handling, how to shoot, how to teach shooting. Not everyone is a teacher. We have a lot of teachers on our staff. And I think that's actually a really key aspect, is understanding hockey and understanding how to teach and how to relate to kids are all really key things that we bring that I don't think everyone, they don't always get in minor hockey.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, I couldn't recall if I asked you that. One of the other questions that I did jot down earlier that I thought would be interesting to get from you is, I've noticed through a lot of the spring and summer camps that are out there to choose from, come with big names, come with like your Strudwicks, your Browns, your McDavids, using PEP, if you will. Why would someone want to come to your program unless they've done the research and know where you guys have played, but why would someone come to your program? What can you offer that's different out there?
Yeah, I think that's a good question. And, I'll wind the clock back a little bit to the 70s and 80s when Jim Fleming ran the Vermilion Summer Vacation Hockey School. And, they went through the big names, right? And the big names do help with enrollment, right? People will come. We had Grant Fuhr 1 year, so, people come. And, I think in general what Jim found was, the big names, they're not necessarily – he didn't find some of them were as committed, and he found the quality of instructors that he could get from people outside the big names was as good or sometimes better. So our focus is on a quality product. Not having the big names helps keep our costs very reasonable, and so that's really our focus. Is we want to give we want to offer something that's reasonable price that most families can afford. And, they get the quality education from it. We had a quote from former Oilers coach Ted Green, whose grandson attended the camp. And he said, this is the best hockey school I have ever seen. So, those type of endorsements mean a lot to us. I mean, for us, this is a week's vacation that this is how we spend our family vacation time, is in a hockey rink. And mm-hmm. So, we wouldn't do it if we didn't love it. And then, we just hope that people are able to benefit from it and appreciate it.
For sure. Mark, where can individuals go to get some more information about your skills development program this summer?
So best place is our website. It's FlemingHockeySkillsCamp.com. And then we do have a couple hashtags. There's, hashtag hockey camp, YAG camp, or family camp. So that would be the best place to go, and everything should be there as far as camp information, registration information, and all that.
That's good. Good to hear. Mark, do you mind sticking around with us while we bring on our next guest and maybe bring you in near the end?
Sounds great.
Awesome. Everyone, when we come back from commercial break, we're going to bring in Carly Haggard, the U18 female coach out at Shawnigan Lake. Thanks for joining us, Mark. Hopefully you can stick around.
You bet. Thank you.
At Super 8 Winnipeg West, we have your comfort in mind with free Wi-Fi and free daily Superstart breakfast. We also have guest laundry facilities, a state-of-the-art fitness center, and a jetted hot tub. Sleep well in a spacious guest room equipped with plush new bedding, a 50-inch flat-screen HD TV, microwave, mini refrigerator, and Keurig coffee maker. Or book a suite with a kitchen, ideal for extended stays. Super 8 Winnipeg West, located just inside the perimeter on Portage Avenue.
Welcome back, everybody, to On the Ice. We're now joined by Carly Haggard, one of my second favorite coaches out there I think is very blessed to get to hang out in Victoria for the entire hockey season. Talk about a slack job.
Oh, yeah. Beautiful today, too.
Yeah, not like the rest of us, all Canadians that get sheltered and have to hide under our kitchen tables when it's cold outside. How are things out there at Shawnigan? How are things looking for the upcoming season? Let's start with, how is everybody? How's everybody looking out there?
Things have been great this year. We've been so fortunate. We have, since September, we've been on the ice 5-6 days a week. So player development has been amazing. The kids have been in person, in class learning since day one. So we've been very, very fortunate here out at Shawnigan. And things have been great. And as you can see behind me, it's another beautiful day here. So no, we've been very lucky and everyone's been doing very well.
What's scouting going to look like, or what has scouting looked like for you guys? Obviously, due to the C word that I don't allow anyone on our shows to say. But how's it looking with that?
So this is, we've actually, again, myself has been pretty fortunate. We only have 5 seniors and 2 are actually coming back for a gap year. So we really only have 3 to 4 spots to fill. And have kind of have tentative offers out, or people put an application to the school of people that I've previously seen. So at my summer camp last year, and kind of followed throughout this year and kept in contact with them, because I imagine like last spring, there won't be much traveling and recruiting that way. So again, pretty fortunate in that manner.
Mm-hmm. Now, not to toot your own horn and to jump forward a little bit in the interview, I don't know if anybody knows who Ms. Haggard is, but she did play for Team Canada. Do you think that that's what's brought a lot of the students your way to come out to the island to get coached by a former Olympian?
I think it's certainly, and not an Olympian, been on the world championship. So definitely not an Olympian, but I still wore the Team Canada jersey. So, I think it definitely doesn't hurt. But in my opinion, what we offer here at Shawnigan Lake School is what brings most students, the academics, the facilities, the kind of the whole package that we can offer here is, I think, what attracts students. And, you know, obviously having a pretty good playing career, this is my 10th year of coaching as a background, certainly helps in that manner. But, I think kind of what the Shawnigan Lake School itself offers is what really attracts people here.
Now, talking about that, let's talk about the campus. Could you share with us, obviously, all of the students, I assume, are in the dorms. There's no outside activity. It's, you're here, you're in the dorm. Could you maybe just give us, an envision of what the campus looks like?
Well, if you have seen Harry Potter, it's a lot of people compare it to Hogwarts, the dining hall and the dorms and stuff. So that's kind of your visual. But the school itself has 520 students. There is approximately 60 day students. So there is a few day students if you live in Shawnigan Lake, Duncan, Mill Bay, Cobble Hill area. But yeah, the majority are boarders. So they come from all over the world, North America, Europe, Asia, all over. There's 11 boarding houses, so there's no co-ed. Right now there is 6 boys dorms and 5 girls. So there's approximately 40 to 50 kids per dorm. So yeah, that's kind of how the setup is. A big main building with all the administration, dining hall. In non-C times, all the students eat together. So in the dining hall, for breakfast, there's 700 because staff eat there as well. So over 700 staff for breakfast, lunch, and sometimes dinner. So yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful campus. We have our own rink right on campus, world-class gym facilities. So everything is right here within walking distance. I think it takes about, from where the buildings are structured, 10 minutes to walk from one side to the other. So kind of everything is right here at your fingertips.
I'm getting jealous listening to this. It's I've been out there, I've seen the campus, and I still don't understand why my daughter didn't want to continually move west instead of moving east. But anyhow.
Yeah, wrong decision, that's for sure.
Yeah, it's a beautiful campus. Now, what can you maybe tell our viewers what Shawnigan offers education-wise? Like, there's different programs that the students can take, and education is a key. It should be something that all parents are looking at. So what does Shawnigan offer education-wise for our students?
So we are one of the top boarding schools for education in North America. And I'm a teacher myself. I teach at the school as well as coach. So obviously I'm very passionate about the academic side of things. And, you know, I always say to people, you're a student first and you're an athlete second. I mean, especially in female hockey, you know, the most that we can hope would be the top is, you know, the Olympics, maybe play professional, but more realistically, we're looking for a university degree, right? And play hockey at university. So that is our number one goal as female hockey players. So, you know, you have to focus on academics, as that's what's going to take you places. So yeah, we have phenomenal teachers. Again, teachers here come from all over the world. You know, some stay long term, some come and do sabbaticals, but the thing that sets this place apart, I think, in the academics is so many staff live on campus. So I actually live in one of the boys' boarding houses. So I'm in charge, along with another staff member, of 15 teenage boys. So not sure what I was thinking there, but staff are always, staff are always involved and we're always here. We eat with the students. We offer tutorials morning and night. You know, it's not just a 9-to-3 teaching job, where even though that's not most teachers, but we're here all the time. We're always offering tutorials. We're always at the students. We see them all the time, see them at lunch and talk about papers and essays and, you know, really want them to succeed. And, you know, one of my assistant coaches, he's an English teacher and he's been here for 16 years and he brings exams on the road when we go with us. And, you know, he's able to take tests and do papers and vigilate different exams. So it's really, we're all kind of work as one, the athletics and the academics is kind of one together.
That's so good to hear. I'm not sure a lot. Most Canadian sports school hockey league establishments do have some type of education backup plan for when the kids are on the road, but definitely Shawnigan is one of the leaders out there that I can see that has its own campus, which all inclusive in a way. And that's so good. Just you guys are so far away.
Yeah. It makes it even better.
Yeah. Right. Eh? Get away from the parents. Go. Yeah. Learn all you can. Now what if Shawnigan offering this spring and summer for any camps? Are you guys going to be able to offer anything to the outsider who wants to come in and maybe get their feet wet to see what Shawnigan's like? And I would like to stress to our viewers that Shawnigan is not just a hockey school. It actually does have rowing, I believe rugby, basketball, I believe, mm-hmm. and music, I understand there's music there as well, and soccer, and I believe kayaking, correct?
Yeah, whitewater rafting.
Yeah, so it's more than just hockey. The specific reason we're talking to Ms. Haggard today is about the hockey. So, but I just wanted our viewers to know that you guys offer much more than that. So what is the hockey program looking like over the spring and summer? Will we be able to have any activities that you can invite some outsiders to come and see and get their feet wet?
Yeah, so we are doing a hockey camp here August 9th to the 13th. This will be our third year doing it. The last 2 years, we only offered it to midget age players. And this year, we're looking to expand. So we're going to do bantam and midget age players. So I believe it's 2008 to 2002 birth years. So that'll be not August 9th to the 13th. At the Shawnigan Lake School Arena, the Charlie Purdy Arena. So yeah, we're looking to do that for that week in August, and yeah, open to anyone and everyone.
And where can individuals go to get that information? Carly, is that up on your website currently, or should they just reach out to you?
Yeah, so if you just reach out to me, my email will be on the website. You can just shoot me an email, and then I can send you all the contact information and details regarding that. It'll be two ice sessions a day, one sport-specific off ice, and then usually one activity. We go kayaking, hiking, and there's so many amazing outdoor things to do here. So we like to take advantage and, you know, show the girls kind of the area.
We have to take a quick commercial break, Carly. Please hang in there, and we will be right back with some more stuff about Shawnigan Lake School.
Thanks.
Hi, I'm JD Houghton, host of the SAS Sports Show. Catch it every Thursday at 5 p.m. Central Standard Time for all things Saskatchewan sports.
Welcome to Pilot-Mound Hockey Academy, your world-class academic and hockey training facility created to maximize each student's athletic and academic potential. Blackjack Stewart Arena, home of the Buffalo, is inside the 46,000-square-foot complex, as well as a curling rink and other facilities. The students have a unique combination of successful, well-rounded education at Pilot-Mound Collegiate Institute and the professional hockey training in an encouraging community. The years of experience of on-ice coaching propel our students to the next level, both mentally and physically, in a professional environment.
Well, there was an advertisement from another Canadian sports school hockey league team, the Pilot-Mound Buffaloes, that I'm sure Ms. Haggard is looking forward to kicking some butt next season.
Absolutely.
Pretty positive of that. There's just a little rivalry with all of the female teams across Canada.
Always, yeah.
So before we left, we were just talking about some of the other sports. Please excuse me, I was trying to get down a granola bar. Some of the other sports that are at Shawnigan and what you guys have planned for this season. So you brought up something that I found really cool. So when they get to come to the camp, they get to go some on ice, and then they get to go kayaking or canoeing or some other things. You guys have, how many acres is Shawnigan Lake School on, and what other cool things do you do with your teams? Like, that is wicked. That's awesome.
Yeah, I believe over 300 acres, the trails behind the school. So one of the projects that some students have decided to take on is they're building mountain bike trails behind the school. So there's mountain biking, about 200 meters behind me is the lake. So hockey is probably the newest program, sport athletics program at Shawnigan. Rowing has been around for years and years, and rugby is kind of, you know, how the school started, the pinnacle of Shawnigan athletics. And, you know, you have field hockey and, like you said, musical and theater, and all students, regardless of why you come to Shawnigan, they actually have to play a sport and they have to do a fine art. So all the hockey kids, you know, on the days that we don't do hockey, they have to do a fine art. So some are in the musical, you have woodworking, pottery, photography, really trying to create that all around experience and, you know, not just so focus on one aspect of your life. And to me, that's what makes it so special here is you could be this top hockey player, this top rugby player, and then you're singing in the musical. And to me, that's what's so special here.
That'd be so funny. The
yeah, biggest, it's great.
The biggest U20, like 6'2" goalie standing there from a male team and singing in a musical.
Yeah, that's exactly what happened last year. One of the boys on the U18 prep team, he was the lead singer in the musical, and he was outstanding. That was amazing.
Well, at least we know if hockey doesn't work out.
That's exactly right. Yeah, you got your second here. Yeah.
Yeah. With our earlier guest that we had today, Mr. Mark Fleming, they run a skills development program out of Edmonton, Alberta. And one of the things I touched with him is just how skills have been changing over the years. You've been around hockey your whole life, Carly. There's no doubt, just the background you have. What have you noticed over the last few years about skill development? And I'm trying to be political in this in saying that it's almost better to send your child to a privately ran establishment like the Skills Camp, like Mr. Fleming runs, as well as Shawnigan Lake School, because you're getting that focus. What can and what have you seen over the years of our skills? Like, I've noticed as a scout, it's gone down a bit. But when you go and you watch some of our more competitive players, like in the Alberta Female Hockey League, as well as the girls program that they run out in BC and in Saskatchewan, it's better with the older kids. Where do you think it's lacking, and why do you think more parents are looking at privately ran facilities for their players?
I think one of the main reasons that skill development per se has gone down is I don't think females, especially I'll speak about the female game, is they don't watch hockey. They don't watch the NHL. They don't watch the WNHL. They just don't watch the game. And to me, that's where you learn so much. And that's where you really gain your hockey IQ from. So I think the individual skill has gone up. So I think the skating and the shooting and the strength and conditioning has gone up in female players. But I think the hockey IQ and the read and react and just the knowledge of the game itself has gone down. And I think that's because we don't watch hockey enough, because we're making kids do so much. You have to go to school and you have to do this sport and that sport and do this. And you don't have time to just sit and watch a hockey game. And to me, that's where you can pick up so much and learn so much of the game. And that's where I think one thing is really lacking. And I see it when I watch, you know, Bantam, especially, and, you know, into Pee Wee, not so much because they're still learning the game, but Bantam and into the younger years of midget, is they don't know the game. And that's because they don't watch the game and they don't have someone to teach them the game, right? They have someone to teach them how to shoot. And that's what I think is so important. When you go to someone who's experienced in hockey and has that knowledge, they can help teach them the game. And that's where sets the good players, the great players from the good players, is, you know, read and reacting off puck skills is so important, right? So I think that's the major difference.
What have you guys noticed at Shawnigan with the quality of players that have been rolling out of your doors? You can speak to the female side if you wish. But what seems to be the thing that's really rolling out, the quality of player?
To me, I think it's we're helping them become that all-around player. You know, you hear so many people, or that's a great player, but they lack in the defensive zone coverage. That's a great player, but they lack in this area. You know, everyone's going to have their strengths and weaknesses, but we want to make sure that, you know, we're sending to universities the all-around player, the coachable player, someone who wants to learn and work hard and get better, and, you know, a real team player. And, you know, we have set such a great culture at Shawnigan, and to me, that is so important. And that's someone that you want to send on, someone who, you know, they're going to say, at, you know, Brock University, we're looking for this player. And that player is a Shawnigan Lake School player, alumni, right? So, you know, someone who can encompass all that and, you know, just really work hard and have a great attitude and, you know, have that all around skill and not have those areas that they really lack in.
Yeah, definitely makes sense. We got to take another commercial break. When we come back, I want to have Mr. Fleming join the conversation, and then we'll wrap it up. We'll be right back. I'm getting inundated by all these new buttons I can press. Like, there's this button. Watch this. I have way too much fun with my job. I enjoy this job, talking to people across Canada and the world. And anyways, Mark, well, let me unmute you, buddy. I muted you. My apologies. Mr. Fleming and Ms. Haggard, thank you guys so much for being on the show today. Really appreciate it. Just wanted to wrap up with both of you on the screen. Definitely, you both have iterated that skill development is a key that we all need to look at and be able to help our players with. Mark, just quickly, your camp that's coming up, what's registration look like? And just let our viewers know again in Alberta and Saskatchewan and BC where they can go to register, please.
Sure. So again, it's August 16th to 20th in Millwoods, and go to FlemingHockeySkillsCamp.com. And we're looking forward to our first ever all-girls division this year, and maybe we can develop some young players to send Carly's way.
I'm sure she'd love that, trust me. Carla, please tell our viewers where they can go to join your guys' skill development camp and get the experience of Shawnigan Lake.
Yeah, so our camp is August 9th to the 13th, Bantam group and a midget group, and you can email me at carlyhaggard@gmail.com for more information.
Awesome. Guys, thanks so much for joining us on the show today. Really appreciate it. Don't go anywhere. I want to come back with you guys. Everyone, thanks for joining us on the Ice, and we'll see you all soon.